Hi, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. This video is part of the series Multithreading with Qt. In the previous video, we talked about QThread and how to start threads, how to wait for threads. In this video, what I would like to talk to you about is using event loops in threads. So there are two ways to use QThread, without an event loop or with an event loop. And as a reminder of the previous video, we said if you want to execute code in a thread, you can re-implement run and then call start from the outside. So it would lead to code like this, where we re-implement run, we do a number of things like loading from disk, doing calculations, reporting results. And once all of that is done, the run method finishes, and then that means the thread is done. In this video, I want to talk to you more about event loops and event handling. Let's have a look at the fact how it works in Qt. A Q object is always associated to a thread, and that is the thread that handles the event for that object. So we can represent it like in this diagram, where we have three different threads and we have objects that live in these threads. What this means is that any event that is sent to one of those objects will be handled in that thread. It also means if we connect signals and slots, they will be handled, the slot will be handled in the thread associated to this object. But we'll talk more about signals and slots in the next video. So we have event loops in different threads, and this is where the event handling happens. So let's have a look at how to do this in code. We have this thread here that creates a socket, and we want to handle all of the events from that socket in that thread. All we have to do is create the socket at the beginning of run. And then once all of the setup is done, maybe we connect to signals and then we are ready, we can call the exec method. Exec in a QThread is what is going to start the event loop of the thread. So everything will happen from there, all the event handling. And at some point when maybe the socket gets disconnected and we want to finish handling that socket and finish the thread, all we have to do is call the quit method or the exit method on the event loop. And in this case, these are methods in QThread, which will exit the event loop. And that means exec will return and run will return and we are done. What is interesting though, is to realize that the run method is actually not a pure virtual. It has a default implementation, which is to call exec. So if we want, we can do the setup separately and simply create a QThread, and we don't have to derive from QThread anymore. So what we can do, like in this example, is create a QThread without deriving, just new QThread. Then we are going to create a worker object. This is simply the object where the work is going to be done. And we create the started signal of QThread to a slot in worker, which is where the work is going to be done. This way, when the thread is ready and has started, the worker is going to do the work. When the worker has results for us, it will emit a signal. Let's call it work done. We can connect to that, obviously, to get the results. But also, we can connect this signal to the quit method of the thread. And this is how the thread will actually finish at some point. And when it finishes, it will emit the finished signal, which we connect to the delete later slot of the worker. And this is how the worker gets deleted. Okay, we have done all of the connections. What's really important now is we need to move the worker to that secondary thread. This move to thread method is how we are saying the event handling for this worker is going to be in that secondary thread. And now everything is set up. We simply have to call start on the thread, and this is where everything starts. So this is a pattern that has been around for a long time. It works nicely. The problem I have with it is that it forces us to handle two different objects, the worker and the thread, and take care of both being deleted and so on. This is not very object-oriented. I would like to have a single object that takes care of both. And this is a pattern that we can use called the active object, where we are going to move the thread into the worker object. And this way, from the outside, we don't even see that there is a secondary thread anymore. All we see is the worker. And the way this works is, in the implementation of the worker, we will have a thread that is implemented or stored in this member variable, mThread. So the first thing we do is to create the thread instance with new QThread. Be careful, never pass a parent to that object. We'll talk more in the next video about why. So we have this QThread object. Now we want to use it for the event handling of the worker, and we do that with the moveToThread call here. Okay, we are ready, we can start the thread. When the thread is about to finish, from the outside, we don't know that it's a thread. What we do from the outside is, okay, let's delete the worker. Now we have some cleanup to do, and we want this cleanup to be done in the secondary thread, not in the main thread, which is where this destructor is being called. So what we can do then is to use the invoke method to call this cleanup slot in the secondary thread. Because all of the events for that object are handled in the secondary thread, this means the slot will be called there, which means we can do any kind of cleanup we need, deleting a timer, a socket, or whatever, in the right thread, the one that handles the events. And then we can say thread quit, which will make exec return, so the run method that we don't see has actually finished. Okay, so this means all of the cleanup is done. In the destructor, all we have to do now is call wait, so that we wait for this cleanup to be done. And then at the end of the destructor, the thread instance will be deleted because it's a unique pointer. So all of the cleanup is done properly, and we can finish and return from the destructor. So what I like with this pattern is that it can be used for things like handling a socket in a different thread, but we don't actually see the thread. All we see is the socket handler. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll talk about synchronization and data races. If you want to be notified when this video comes out, you can subscribe to our channel. Thank you.